Good afternoon, everyone. My topic is today about the refugee, and this topic about his Syrian, his child, he was in the war, so he wanted like to look for safety, but he did when he came by boat. Yeah. So now I'm gonna talk about it more in more details. Refugee who arrived by boat without authorization should have the opportunity to apply for a visa and not be sent back to their countries. We all know that there is a war in some of the Arab countries and how a lot of people are trying to go to different countries to look for safety and for a good future. There are many people applying for a visa to different countries and also to Australia, yet they are being refused. They cannot find another legal way, as they are refused yet need to live in safety. For this reason, they are starting to make their way to Australia illegally by boat without a visa. The Australian government is failing to give them a chance to apply for a visa, and is instead sending them back to their countries in the same way by boat. Some of these refugees are dying by traveling via boat without enough food, without enough drinks, also with the dangers of the ocean. The refugee who arrived without a visa by sea continue to be subjected as at Syria April 2017. There, 1,392 people were held in cross immigration, 377 of whom were asylum seekers who had arrived by boat. On 21 May 2017, the Minister for Immigration announced that if the people fail to apply for protection visas by 1 October 2017. Also, 21 boats carrying 740 people had been turned back. Evan Jones. He is a program coordinator at the Asia-Pacific Refugee Rights Network. Has said that in the eyes of the Australian government, irregular boat arrivals are deemed to be criminals, law breakers, and queue jumpers, and not deserving enough to enter Australia. I don't understand why the government thinks in this way about the refugee. The refugees are flying in the wars in their country in order to look for safety, because they feel so tired from the homes. They cannot live their life. They cannot make their dreams to come true. They cannot sleep. So how is that they look like criminals? Yet they are just running away from the war. It's not good to judge people just from outside view. If the Australian government thinks about the refugee in this close-minded points of view, they should at least talk to them first to get more details about them, instead of judging them on that they because they have arrived illegally into Australia. I am always asking myself how the Australian government is not giving these refugees the chance to apply for a visa, and are instead sending them back to their countries. This is just outright unbelievable. At the same time, we can see that Australia is a good and a free country. It provides free food, like also water, healthcare, and a free opinion in order to help the poor people. That is what makes me feel sad. Why does Australia government like to end it like that? Why are they doing that without feeling any remorse for this refugee? At least it should give them a chance to apply for a visa. And at this time, the Australian government cannot choose any area to put the refugee in it, chance to apply for a visa. And this time, the Australian government can choose for them any area to live in it at this time, just for a short time, to get more details about them, about how they are living, about also how they were living in the world, to know if they have kids who should study after school, and if they feel scared, to wait to see if their application been refused or accepted to enter Australia. If the Australian government still wants to send them back to their home, country, the government should have at least some feelings towards these refugees. They don't have anyone to be with them, to help them. So, Australia shouldn't send them back to their countries in the same way by boat, because that will be so dangerous of them. When they came to Australia, some of them died while traveling by boat, without enough food, without drinks. Also, they are in desperate need for safety from the wars around their homes. So the Australian government shouldn't send them back in the same way. So what they should be doing is giving them permanent refugee if they claim for is a claim for asylum is found to be accurate for sending them back in a safer way, for example, by plane. I know how the people feel in the war. I know how it's hard is to live in a country where the war is. I know this because I came from Syria 1 year ago. And I have also some big stats. That's a big explosion in Syria. I was there at this moment. So, every day I would wake up to the loud and the terrifying noise of the bombs. I can never forget the time when 80 bombs were exploded in my area. In the same day, yes, 80 bombs in one day, and just one on a part of our capital. I was so scared, especially since these 80 bombs came to our building. When all of us at work, we woke up early, and there was a big explosion in Qusra, an area in the capital of Damascus. Many innocent people were left wounded or dead. Every single day there are a lot of bombs and big explosions. The war has been there from 2011 till now, 2018. I know that I came to Australia by plane by safe way, but that doesn't mean I don't feel empathy towards the refugees who are arriving by boat. So why doesn't the Australian government give them a chance to apply for a visa instead of sending them back to their countries? Please, let's wake up the sense of humanity. We should be one. We need to help each other. We should stop the war, help the refugees, stop the government from sending the refugees back to their country. Let's give them a chance to apply for a visa. Australia is a good and free country. It helps the people. It provides healthcare, food, and a lot of things for the people. So please do a favor and help the refugees.